I think when we talk about sustainability of commercial fishing, a lot of times that is relegated just to how many fish are in the ocean. And I think it needs to be more than that. It needs to be about business practices. If you are a fisherman and you're throwing your nets in the landfill, that may be easier for you, but if it's made out of plastic, we should be recycling it. So I wanted to provide an opportunity for fishermen to get rid of those items. My name is Nicole Baker, and I am the owner of Net Your Problem. The event that we're hosting today is a spring cleaning event. So we're encouraging fishermen from three ports around the Puget Sound to go through their gear lockers and get rid of anything that they are not using anymore.
One of the best parts of the work I do with trinamiX is interfacing with all of these community recycling programs. Most people know about curbside recycling at home, but at least half of what's out there is actually recovered by smaller community groups. So we're with Nicole from Net Your Problem, and we're also here with people from BASF.
BASF is the global leader in the chemical industry. One of the work we are doing when it comes to plastic material is look for end-of-life solutions for plastics. Net Your Problem is a company that is working in this special niche, which is the end-of-life fishing.
There is viability to actually creating a circular economy around these materials and showing the world that this is possible, this is doable.
Circular economy is extending the useful life of plastics that have already been manufactured. So instead of using it once and throwing it out when it no longer has any use, you try to keep that item in circulation for as long as possible.
In this case, one potential outcome is that you can take these fishing nets and convert them in other products like frames for chairs, for example, or a housing for a power tool.
Plastic identification is really one of the most important steps in our recycling value chain. Not all plastics are built alike, and so not all plastic types can be brought into a new material together. You really need to segment them.
Most gear is made out of a variety of types of plastic. So if you think about a gill net, the corks are made out of a different plastic than the cork line, which is a different kind of plastic than the web.
Our handheld mobile near-infrared spectrometer really enables small communities to sort their plastic waste.
We use this device to help us tell what kind of plastic fishing gear is made out of. It gives us on-demand identification of the plastics. So that helps us when fishermen drop off a new line that we've not seen before to figure out what pile it goes in.
I think the trinamiX tool provides local fishermen a nice kind of tangible link between what we're doing and where the material is going.
We have chosen to work with trinamiX and BASF because both are companies that have demonstrated that they are interested in working on the ground level with smaller companies like myself, and we need a lot more of that. Big corporations being involved at the local level helps the local communities, but it also sets a precedent on a larger scale that others can follow later. I think people should care about recycling because we are not sustainably utilizing our planet's natural resources.
Only 10% of plastics waste is being recycled.
We need to do better about recycling these materials and finding end-of-life options so they don't end up in a landfill.
It is really difficult work sometimes, but every amount of gear that we divert from the landfill, I think, makes a difference.